Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss one of the new medication, Prucalopride. What is this medication, Prucalopride? This is one of the new medication which is classified as serotonin agonist. So this drug increases the serotonergic transmission, but we have different types of serotonin receptors. Among them, Prucalopride is highly selective for 5-HT4 receptors. 5-HT4 receptors are highly expressed on GI smooth muscle as well as myenteric neurons, and they play important role in the peristalsis of colon. Now, Prucalopride is one of the prokinetic drug which is particularly used in the conditions like chronic idiopathic constipation. So this drug can be given to increase the peristalsis. In the people with constipation, the number of colon movements are reduced. In such conditions, Prucalopride can increase the peristalsis, which improves propulsive movements. So this medication increases the GI motility, thereby can relieve the symptoms of constipation. Before introducing Prucalopride, few of the drugs like Sisapride, Tegaserod, they are available in the market, and these drugs are again serotonin agonists. They are also having the similar activity on 5-HT4 receptors, but these two drugs are not completely selective. Because of less selectivity, these two drugs can induce hepatotoxicity. On the other hand, Prucalopride is a benzofuran derivative which is highly selective for 5-HT4 receptors. Therefore, it is not producing hepatotoxicity. So this is one of the advantages of this new medication, which can be used in the chronic idiopathic constipation without producing any hepatotoxicity. Second advantage is that this medication is not affecting other types of ion channels. Prucalopride is not having any activity on the HERG potassium channels, which are important for cardiac activity. And even it is not showing any activity on 5-HT1 receptors. Due to lack of action on these targets, Prucalopride is not associated with cardiotoxicity. So this drug is not increasing the QT interval in the ECG because it is not acting on HERG potassium channels. So because of high selectivity, Prucalopride is not producing hepatotoxicity as well as cardiotoxicity. And this medication is available as a tablet. It can be used in the adults to treat chronic idiopathic constipation. So today in this video, we are going to see how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see how this drug acts. Already we have discussed that Prucalopride is highly selective for 5-HT4 receptors. But we have so many types of other receptors like 5-HT2A, 5-HT3 and so on. But still, Prucalopride is not showing any activity on 5-HT2A and 5-HT3 receptors. It is highly selective for 5-HT4 receptors. Around 150 times it is more selective because of high selectivity. It is particularly increasing peristalsis of the colon, thereby it can relieve the symptoms of constipation. So within the colon, 5-HT4 receptors are expressed. Now Prucalopride is a highly selective. It can act on the 5-HT4 receptors, which increase the propulsions, and it can increase high amplitude propagating contractions. This results in the peristalsis, thereby it can relieve the symptoms of constipation. Another action of this drug is on the myenteric neurons. The cholinergic neurons can affect muscle contraction within the colon, and these neurons are expressed with again 5-HT4 receptors. Now Prucalopride can act on these receptors, which increase the release of acetylcholine. Now this acetylcholine can increase the muscle contraction, which increases peristalsis. By all of these actions, Prucalopride can relieve the symptoms of constipation. Now let us see the precautions of this medication. One of the important precautions of this medication is that this drug can produce some hypersensitive reactions. So these are the allergic reactions which should be carefully monitored. And this drug can produce some skin rashes, even dyspnea, difficulty breathing. And in few of the people, it can produce some facial edema leading to facial redness. And even pruritus, itching sensation, all these symptoms can be observed in few of the people with use of Prucalopride. These are the hypersensitive reactions which may be associated with further serious effects. But these are the rare side effects observed only in few of the people. So in case of any hypersensitivity, use of Prucalopride is not recommended. Another precaution is that this drug can produce some mood changes. So with use of prucalopride, any development of depressive symptoms should be carefully checked. These depressive symptoms can be developed in the adults as well as in the elders. So this is one of the important precautions of this medication, and even it can increase the suicidal thoughts and suicidal initiation. So during the use of prucalopride, any development of behavior and mood changes should be closely monitored. Another important thing is that this drug should be carefully given in the people with any intestinal disorders. Since this drug is acting on the intestine, any obstruction in the intestine or perforation or even ulceration may interact adversely with the action of prucalopride, which may lead to fatal side effects. That's when such people like Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis or obstructive colons, this prucalopride is not recommended. Now let us see the side effects of this medication. This drug mainly produces abdominal pain, abdominal discomfort, even it can produce some headache, nausea. It can produce a diarrhea because it is going to increase the peristalsis, colon movements are increased. Diarrhea is another important side effect of this medication. Similarly, it can produce some fatigue and dizziness. And in few of the people, it can produce some abdominal distension, and even it can induce the flatulence. Finally, a loss of appetite can also be observed. Now let us see the chemical nature. So this is the structure of prucalopride. Here we can clearly observe the heterocyclic ring system. Let us give the numbering. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So simply it is a benzofuran. And to this benzofuran, at the 7th position, this functional group is attached. This is nothing but the carboxamide. So we can write this as 7-carboxamide. So prucalopride is a benzofuran 7-carboxamide derivative. Now to this benzofuran, at the 4th position, amine group is attached. So 4-amino. 5th position, chlorine group is attached. So 5-chloro. 2nd and 3rd position are saturated. So 2,3-dihydro. Then on the carboxamide, piperazine ring is attached by 4th position. So we can write this as N-piperazine-4-aryl. Now to this piperazine, one of the side chain is present. Let us give the numbering. This is 1, 2, 3. So this chain is nothing but the propyl chain with methoxy group at the 3rd position. So it is nothing but 3-methoxypropyl. That is the complete name of prucalopride. How it is given? This drug is available as a tablet at a strength of 1 mg as well as 2 mg. The dose of prucalopride is started at 2 mg, given once daily. This drug can be given either with food or without food. Food is not having any interaction with absorption and kinetics of prucalopride. And better it should be given on the same time each day to relieve the symptoms of constipation. But in the people with any renal failure with creatinine clearance less than 30 ml per minute, the dose of this prucalopride should be reduced. In such people, it can be given at 1 mg dose, given once daily. So that's all about this medication, prucalopride, which is a 5-HT4 receptor agonist, and it is having high selectivity towards these receptors. Because of high selectivity, it is not producing any damage to the liver as well as heart. So cardiotoxicity as well as hepatotoxicity is not observed with this prucalopride. But this medication should be carefully given because this drug can increase the symptoms of depression, and it can produce some mood changes. Even suicidal thoughts can be induced by this medication. Hypersensitivity is another important precaution that is rarely observed in few of the people. And this drug should not be given in the people with any colon disorders like perforation, ulceration, obstruction, ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease. In such people, use of prucalopride is contraindicated. And this drug is available as a tablet. The initial dose is 2 mg given once daily. But in the people with any renal failure, the dose is reduced to 1 mg given once daily. So that's all about this medication, prucalopride. Hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.